Hello there, welcome to the supply chain universe. Today we will discuss implementing a complex IT project of end-to-end planning and scheduling, which I discussed in the previous video. Today you will know 7 secrets to ensure project success. Unfortunately, more than 90% of projects in this area end in failure for managers and consultants, even if trendy agile approaches were used, although they are certainly very important. So, what makes a successful project? Our project has been configured to integrate more than 10 IT planning, accounting, and execution systems. That is, even from a technical point of view, this is a rather complicated undertaking. The key idea of the project was that it was necessary to combine the model of material flows, the production of raw metal and pipe products. These are completely different industries. In one case, metal roll is assembled according to chemistry, while the pipe is arranged according to geometry. Accordingly, their first task is to combine information on raw metal and pipe products. And the second is to combine scheduling and operational planning in one information field to ensure response speed. Basically, a similar problem in work practice hasn't been solved anywhere until our project. By the way, subscribe to the channel to not miss the content and to motivate me to create new videos. There are still many exciting things to come. Here are 7 key factors of a successful project and why you should strive to meet each step, even before you begin managing and launching your next big idea. Number 1. Trust. Don't start a project if you don't trust your planners. If you don't trust, replace them. The whole team at once, since the trust cannot be bought. And you cannot come up with some reasonable action to create trust. It takes years to earn trust. By the way, by default, any planner will prove to you that any system doesn't work. You have to trust your planners, and they have to rely on you. You're a two-way system of trust for them. Ultimately, planners must believe the results of their actions. Number 2. Choose the best possible software and use the minimum. Anything that seems average today will be an outsider tomorrow. Take only leaders and visionaries from the Gartner Quadrant, but use according to your wishes. Figuratively speaking, buy a Koenigsegg by drive at a speed of 30 km per hour. Number 3. Rely only on yourself. You have no more hope. One of the frequent unfulfilled hopes is that the system will decide for you or your planners. Number 4. Build the whole project on the principles of minimal changes, human, organizational, software, any changes. Number 5. Get rid of the description of the processes as is. You will only waste your time. You already know that the processes as is you don't like. I assure you, after describing it is at ease, the next step is to throw it all in the trash. As is describing is very popular among consultants and vendors working on the principle of T&M, time and material, but are you sure you really need it? Number 6. The principle of discrete decision making. In any project, there should be discrete. Plans don't make any sense if they immediately lead to other changes. You should say that you create a plan once a day for a day and live according to it. The rule of discretion in change management is the rule of execution of decisions made. If you have made a decision, then you must execute it. And the last thing I wanted to say, number 7, don't give up projects even during a pandemic. And of course, a crisis or a pandemic, it's time to finally start thinking about a strategy and not deal with extinguishing fires.